हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी आर स्टार्ट ए यूनिट नंबर सेकंड रेशियो एनालिसिस। इन दिस यूनिट वी हैव टू लर्न द प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम ऑन रेशियो एनालिसिस। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द सेकंड प्रॉब्लम ऑन रेशियो एनालिसिस। हियर सेकंड प्रॉब्लम: As a credit manager of the Central Bank of India, you have been approached by two companies for a loan of rupees 1 lakh for 6 months with no collateral offered, since the bank has almost exhausted its quota for loans of this type. Only one of these requests can be granted. The relevant information supplied to you by the two companies is presented below. म्हणजे तुम्ही क्रेडिट मॅनेजर आहात सेंट्रल बँक ऑफ इंडियाचे, आणि तुम्हाला 1 लाख रुपयाचं लोन काय करायचं आहे, द्यायचं आहे दोन कंपन्यांना, आणि ते आहे 1 लाख रुपये, त्याला कोणती कोलॅटरल सिक्युरिटी जे म्हटली जाते त्या पद्धतीची नसेल, आणि दिलेल्या इन्फॉर्मेशनवरून आता बँक काय करेल तर लिक्विडिटी रेशो कॅल्क्युलेट करेल आणि त्याच्यावरून कोणत्या कंपनीला लोन प्रोव्हाइड करायचं किंवा लोन अप्रूव्ह करायचं हे इथं बघणार आहोत किंवा सोडवणार आहोत। तर इयर पर्टिक्युलर्स: कंपनी एक्स रुपीज, कंपनी वाय रुपीज। इयर ॲसेट्स: कॅश, सन्ड्री डेटर्स, स्टॉक। एक्स कंपनी रुपीज 1,70,000, 2,74,000 अँड 9 लॅख। कंपनी वाय रुपीज कॅश 3 लॅख, सन्ड्री डेटर्स 4,25,000 अँड स्टॉक 13,50,000। टोटल करंट ॲसेट्स 13,44,000। एक्स कंपनीज रुपीज अँड वाय कंपनीज रुपीज, टोटल करंट ॲसेट 20,74,000। Other assets 10 lakh, 10,20,000 respectively. Liabilities and capital of both the company is: current liabilities 5 lakh, 6,40,000 respectively. Long term loans 8 lakh, 10 lakh respectively. Equity share capital 8 lakh, 12 lakh respectively. Retained earnings 2,44,000 and 2,54,000. Total of assets and liability is: company X 23,44,000, company Y 30,94,000, 30,94,000. Here this is the total of company Y liability and this is assets. Okay, here company X 23,44,000 total of asset side and 23,44,000 is total of liability side. Okay, now read the additional information carefully. Additional information: sales is given and rate of gross profit on sales is given. Here sales of X company rupees 24 lakh and company Y is rupees 17 lakh and rate of gross profit on sales is 30% and 40% respectively. Consider the above data and calculate the current and quick ratio of both the companies. With the help of above data, we have to calculate the current ratio of both the companies and liquidity ratio of both the companies. So it is very easy problem to solve a or to find out a liquidity and current ratio of both the companies. Now we are solve this problem. First of all, we write down the formula for finding out the current ratio. Here solution: current ratio company एक्स ओके इज इक्वल टू, कंपनी एक्स इज इक्वल टू करंट एसेट्स अपॉन करंट एसेट्स अपॉन और डिवाइडेड बाय करंट एसेट्स डिवाइडेड बाय करंट लाइबिलिटी, हियर करंट लाइबिलिटी, करंट लाइबिलिटी. So put the figures in the formula, we get a current ratio of company X. So find out the current assets. So current assets of company X column here. Total current assets is given in the problem. So we highlight it, okay, by yellow color. Current total current assets is 13,44,000. Okay, so put this value in the formula. No additional working note for calculating the current ratio. So is equal to thirteen lakh forty four thousand is total current assets divided by total current liability. Here total current liability. So here total current liability is also given in the problem. So current liability is here. Company X current liability is 5 lakh. Okay. Here we find out or we got it the current liability or amount of current liability, that is 5 lakh. Current liability of company X is 5 lakh, so divided by 5 lakh, so we get a current ratio is how much time or how much. So current ratio is 2.69. okay, it is the ratio of current ratio of company X. Now we find out the ratio of here is equal to is the current ratio of company X. Now we find out the current ratio of company Y. Current ratio of company Y is equal to same formula, just put the figures in the formula. So here we copy the formula, current assets divided by current liabilities. Okay, current assets divided by current liability current assets divided by current liability So put the figures in the formula. So find out the current assets of company Y. So in the column of company Y rupees, here total current assets of company Y is 20,74,000. Okay. So put this value in the formula. We get the current ratio of company Y. So here 20,74,000 divided by current liability. So current liability is also given in the problem. It is very easy to calculate the ratio. So current liability of company Y is here 6,40,000. Okay, 6,40,000. So divided by 6,40,000, we get a current ratio of company Y is equal to, so ratio is 3.24. okay, so current ratio of company Y is 3.24 times. Okay, now we are solve the second B part of this problem, that is acid test ratio. We solve a part, that is current ratio of both the companies. Here a part, current ratio of both companies. Okay, now we are find out the liquidity ratio of both the companies. Okay, liquidity ratio of both companies. So formula of finding out the liquidity ratio of both the company is here B. Acid test ratio of both companies. Both means X and Y company. So here acid test ratio company X is equal to quick acid or liquid assets. Quick assets or liquid assets is equal to quick asset or liquid assets is equal to or quick acid liquid asset sorry liquid assets divided by liquid liability divided by liquid liability. So liquid liability or current liability so put the figures in the formula. First of all, we have to find out the liquid assets of the company. So liquid assets of the company is equal to here liquid assets is equal to current assets minus stock minus prepaid expenses. Okay, so total of current assets is given in the problem. So here total of current assets is given in the problem, that is company X 13,44,000. So here 13,44,000 minus stock amount of stock, so amount of stock is company X, okay, amount of stock is 9 lakh, okay, amount of stock is 9 lakh, 9 lakh, so here 9 lakh, okay. So and there is no any prepaid expenses, so let's see the if prepaid expenses is given, then we deduct it from the total current asset. So here no any prepaid expenses is given, so only 9 lakh is less from 13,44,000 is equal to, so here 4,44,000 is liquid assets. 13,44,000 minus 4,44,000. So here we get a liquid assets of company X, that is 4,44,000 is liquid assets of company X. Here we find out the liquid asset of which company? Liquid asset of company company, company X, okay. So put this liquid asset in the formula. So here liquid asset is equal to 4,44,000 divided by liquid liability. Here liquid liability, how we find out the liquid liability? Same as it is. So here liquid liability is equal to current liability minus bank overdraft minus outstanding expenses. Okay, so here put the amount in the formula, we get the liquid liability of the company X. So here company X is equal to current liability is given in the problem. So current liability of company X is 5 lakh and there is no any bank overdraft. 5 lakh minus bank overdraft is not given in the problem, so nil, less outstanding expenses is also not given in the problem, so nil. So the liquid assets is equal to liquid asset is equal to 5 lakh, okay, 5 lakh. Now first of all, to understand the formula, why we write here liquid liability or current liability. Here liquid assets we find out easily, as well as liquid liability is also find out by easy way or with the help of easy formula. Here the current liability should be taken into consideration because the prudence principle has says that the future expenses and losses should taken into consideration while preparing the any statement of any business organization. It means कोणत्याही business organizationचं आपण preparation करत असताना, accounting करत असताना बिझनेसचे फ्युचर लॉसेस असतील, फ्युचर एक्सपेन्सेस असतील, ते आपण प्रोड्यूस कन्सेप्टनुसार विचारात घेतो, परंतु कोणता इन्कम गेन आपण विचारात घेत नाही जो फ्युचरमध्ये आपल्याला होणार आहे तो. म्हणून इथं आपण काय म्हटलेलं आहे की लिक्विड लायबिलिटी मिळाल्या तर शोधून लिहा किंवा तो फाइंड आउट करा, जर नसेल तर करंट लायबिलिटी घेऊनसुद्धा तुम्ही काय करू शकता, तर ते फाइंड आउट करू शकता. तर त्या पद्धती, तर आता इथं आपण फाइंड आउट केलेलं आहे लिक्विड लायबिलिटी इज इक्वल टू 5 लाख. सो हियर वी पुट दिस अमाउंट इन द फॉर्म्युला, सो इज इक्वल टू हियर वी गॉट ए एसिड टेस्ट रेशो इज 0.89 per times. ओके, सो कंपनी एक्स एसिड टेस्ट रेशो इज 0.89. नाउ वी फाइंड आउट द एसिड टेस्ट रेशो ऑफ कंपनी वाई. एसिड टेस्ट रेशो ऑफ कंपनी कंपनी वाई इज इक्वल टू सेम फॉर्म्युला, देर इज नो एनी चेंज इन द फॉर्म्युला. सो पुट द फिगर्स इन द फॉर्म्युला, लिक्विड एसेट्स डिवाइडेड बाय लिक्विड लायबिलिटी. सो हियर वी जस्ट पुट द अमाउंट, सो लिक्विड एसेट्स इज इक्वल टू, सो फाइंड आउट द लिक्विड एसेट्स ऑफ द कंपनी वाय. ओके, सो हियर अगेन वी प्रिपेयर ए वर्किंग नोट फॉर फाइंडिंग आउट द हियर फाइंडिंग आउट द लिक्विड एसेट्स, लिक्विड एसेट्स ऑफ कंपनी वाई इज इक्वल टू सेम फॉर्म्यूला, करंट करंट एसेट्स माइनस स्टॉक स्टॉक माइनस prepaid expenses. So here just put the figures of company Y. Here total assets, current assets 20,74,000 minus stock. So here 20,74,000 minus stock is also given in the problem. So just put this figure in the formula. So here stock of company Y is 13,50,000. So deduct it from current assets. 13,50,000. Okay. Prepaid expenses is not given in the problem, so we write it as nil. Okay, so is equal to, we find out the liquid assets of company Y, so is equal to 7,24,000 is the amount of liquid assets. So 24,000, so how it is find out, 20,74,000 20,74,000 minus 13,50,000. 7,24,000 is a liquid asset of company Y. So here we put this amount in the formula. We did not write the formula again. here we write it the problem. Okay, this is the problem. Sorry, this is the formula, not a problem. We highlight it, liquid assets divided by liquid liability. So did not write again it. So remember this formula, only put the value in the formula, that is 7,24,000 divided by current liability or liquid liability. So how we find out the liquid liability? So it is very easy to find out the liquid liability of organization. Liquid liability of company Y is equal to current liability minus bank overdraft minus bank overdraft minus outstanding expenses. So put the figures in the formula. So current liability is given in the problem. So here is equal to current liability of company X is 6,40,000. So put this value 6,40,000 minus bank overdraft. If given, then deduct it from current liability. So see the liability side here, no bank overdraft is given, no outstanding expenses is given, so all the two is nil. So amount of liquid liability is 6,40,000 remains unchanged, nil minus nil. Okay, not given the problem, so it ignore it. Is equal to 6,40,000 is liquid liability of company Y. So put this amount in the formula, we get a liquid or acid test ratio of company Y. So here 6,40,000. So 7,24,000 divided by 6,40,000 is equal to, we find out the acid test ratio of company Y is equal to 1.13 times. Okay, so this is the liquid ratio of company Y, and all these are the working notes here. So in our today's lecture, we find out the current asset ratio of company X and company Y, as well as acid test ratio of both the companies, company X and company Y. So in our next lecture, we are solve next problem on ratio analysis. Okay, so if you have any query about this problem, then ask me or told me. Okay, thank you very much.